I just got a message from Zoom saying I need to update the Zoom client. I'm going to show you how to do that. First, I am leaving this Zoom meeting, and as I do that, as I'm leaving the meeting, I get a message saying that this update is available. Okay, so I'm currently on 530 and 531 is available. Now, it's got all of this stuff in here, which I usually don't worry about. Minor bug fixes, calendar integration sync improvement. What does that mean? If I want to dig a little bit deeper, and most people don't want to, but if I want to dig a little bit deeper, I would go across to here in the Zoom Help Center and have a look at the releases. And you can get to see things like, what do these releases include? For example, when you delete a meeting in the desktop Zoom client, that's also going to delete the calendar event on the synced calendar, say, for example, if you've got Google Calendar. Because that's a bit annoying if you delete the meeting in Zoom, but it still appears in the Google Calendar or in Outlook, right? The studio effects allow me to add a mustache and a beard and lip colors and stuff like that. This feature is currently in beta, so the makeup room is still under development by the looks of it. But there are a few other things here that are pretty interesting. This one, the self-select breakout room. So a breakout room is where you can, if you've got a meeting with a few different people, you can assign as the host, you can say, I want these people in this breakout room and these ones in that breakout room. You can actually turn this on so the participants can decide which of those breakout rooms, those small rooms, they're going to be in with other people. So this is a really nice little feature. There are some other things really about appearances, especially in chat, how things appear, you know, things have been read or unread for images and files, and even searching the messages, because the chat messages are used a lot more these days. Let me go back to the meeting. After I left the meeting, I got this message that I can update. And to do that, I would just hit update, just like that, and you can see how fast it's all going to happen. In fact, I'm actually going to cancel that, and I'm going to say not now. And the reason I'm going to do that is I'm going to show you two other ways that I could do the update. So way number one is to go zoom.us/download, and then you can select what you're going to be downloading. Okay, Zoom client for meetings, and then I can just download that. So I'm on an Apple Mac, on a MacBook. So if I click on download here, I can click on this and then, you know, follow the bouncing ball. Do I want to install this for all users of this computer or just for me? And continue and so on, click install. So that's one way of doing it. And the other way is when I go into Zoom, up the top here, I can go Zoom, check for updates. Okay, about Zoom. About Zoom shows you what version you're running and check for updates. And that also gives me this dialogue update available. So I don't have to do it after I log out of a meeting. I can just simply do that Zoom.check for updates. And so I'll do that update now. So that's all happening now. You see the progress bar. Then we'll be in business. And I can just click on install. And it's the similar dialogue to the one you just saw before when I hit the download button. That's all good. And now I can check my Zoom version. But if I go into Zoom, about Zoom here on the top left, and my Zoom version has been updated to 5.3.1. So that should give me all of those features that were mentioned in those releases, 531 and 530. I just got a message from Zoom saying that I need to update the